This is the course notes of algorithm and programming 2, which is held at the department. And we are following the book, which is written by Tony Geddes. And the name of the book is Starting Out with Java from Control Structures Through Objects. In this chapter, we are going to discuss about the swing and AWT class hierarchy, read-only text fields, and we are going to handle with lists. What is the meaning of the combo boxes? Actually, we are familiar with the combo boxes. As you remember, in last week we discussed about this issue. And displaying images in labels and buttons, and mnemonics and tooltips. This chapter is a little bit long, and we will continue with file chooser and color choosers and menus, more about text components, text areas and fonts, sliders, look and feel. Last week, we distinguished the differences between Java AWT package and Java's Swing package. As you see in this figure, if we are discussing about Java AWT package, then we have to think about this part of the system. And it means we have object, component, container, window, frame. This part of the system is called Java AWT package. What about Java's Swing package? Here in this part of the system we have J components, and then as you see here, J panel, J text component, J label, abstract button, and under abstract button we have J button, J toggle button, and J radio button, J checkbox. And in J text component we have J text field. This is the general view of the Java IWT package and Java's Swing package. What is the meaning of read-only text fields? Read-only text fields are a different way to use the JText field component. The JText field component has a method named setEditable. And this is the general statement for setEditable. And as you see here, after you write setEditable, then in the parentheses, you have to use Boolean and then editable. By default, a text field is editable. And the setEditable method must be called and passed false to make the field read-only. You can see the definition of a list. A list is a component that displays a list of items and allows the user to select items from the list. The JList component is used for creating lists. When an instance of the JList class is created, an array of objects is passed to the constructor. It means this statement is valid for JList. Just you are typing JList and in the parentheses object, and you remember the meaning of the brackets here, and then array. This represents an array. The JList component uses the array to create the list of items. For example here, string, and then we have brackets here, and then names. It means we have an array. And in array, we are using in the quotation mark, as you see here, there are names, and we are using curly braces then we are putting all names as array in the quotation mark. As you see here, Bill, Jerry, Greg, Jean, Kirk, Philip, Susan. And JList name list is equal to new JList names. Now I want to explain how can we select modes of JList. There are some modes as you see here. The first one is single selection mode. It means only one item can be selected at a time, as you can understand from the statement what you are seeing here in red color. Single interval selection mode means multiple items can be selected, but they must be in a single interval. An interval is a set of contiguous items. And multiple interval selection mode means in this mode, multiple items may be selected with no restrictions. This is the default selection mode. Now we can understand better if we check this slide together. And I want to distinguish the differences between single mode or multiple mode, etc. In the first box, you see there are names, what we discussed previously. But if you are using the single selection mode, it means every time you can select only one name from this box. Multiple interval selection mode means, for example here, first you are selecting Jerry, Greg, John, and then there is another name which is located below these names, below Kirk, and this is Philip. You can select these names together if you use multiple interval selection mode. And single interval selection mode allows a single interval of contiguous items to be selected. Please distinguish the difference between this box and this box. Here you select only once. Every time you can select only one name, but you can select here more than one name sequentially if you use single interval selection mode. If you want, you can change a JList component selection mode with the set selection mode method. The method accepts an integer argument that determines the selection mode. And these are the examples what we are discussing. Here, list selection model dot single selection. And in the second row, you see list selection model single interval selection. And in the third example, you see multiple interval selection. Example, name list dot set selection mode. In the parentheses, just you are typing list selection model single selection. What is list events? When an item in a JList object is selected, it generates a list selection event. The event is handled by an instance of a list selection listener class, which must meet the following requirements. It must implement the list selection listener interface. It must have a method named value changed. This method must take an argument of the list selection event type. Use the add list selection listener method of the JList class to register the instance of the list selection listener class with the list object. When the JList component generates an event, it automatically executes the value changed method of the list selection listener object. It passes the event object as an argument. Now I want to go through about the retrieve selected items. How can we do it? You may use getSelectedValue or get selected index to determine which item in a list is currently selected. Get selected value returns a reference to the item that is currently selected. And for doing that, just you are typing this statement. String selected name, and selected name is equal to string name list get selected value. This is the format for retrieving the selected items. The return value must be cast to a string is required in order to store it in the selected name variable. If no item in the list is selected, the method returns null. We know the meaning of the null, it means nothing there. The getSelectedIndex method returns the index of the selected item or minus 1 if no item is selected. Internally, the items that are stored in a list are numbered similar to an array. Each item's number is called its index. And the first item has the index 0. Please do not forget it. We discussed several times about this issue. And in Java programming language, index begins with 0. You can use the index of the selected item to retrieve the item from an array. For example, in this statement, you see the names. And then just you put JList NameList new JList names. Okay, you see a code here, and this code could be used to determine the selected item. First of all, you type integer index, and then string selected name, and index NameList, and get selected index, and if index not equal minus 1, then selected name is equal to names index. And it is written in the brackets. Please pay attention. In this slide, we will learn about border list. And for doing that, the setBorder method can be used to draw a border around a JList. This is the JList, and we want to draw a border around the JList, and in this box you see the names of the month, and we can create it using this statement: month list, set border, border factory, create line border means this part of the window, and color should be selected as black. As you see, the color of the box is black. How can we add a scroll bar to a list? By default, a list component is large enough to display all of the items it contains. Sometimes a list component contains too many items to be displayed at once. Most GUI applications display a scroll bar on list components that contain a large number of items. List components do not automatically display a scroll bar. To display a scroll bar on a list component, follow these general steps. You have to follow these steps sequentially. Set the number of visible rows for the list component. Create a scroll pane object and add the list component to it, and add the scroll pane objects to any other containers such as panels. For this list, we are using this one, what we studied previously. Establish the size of the list component using this statement, name list, set visible row count 3, create a scroll pane object and add the list component to it. A scroll pane object is a container that displays scroll bars on any component it contains. the jscroll pane class to create a scroll pane object. We pass the object that we wish to add to the scroll pane as an argument to the jscroll pane constructor. And jscroll pane, scroll pane new, jscroll pane name list. Add the scroll pane object to any other containers that are necessary for our GUI. JPanel, panel, new panel, panel add scroll pane, add panel. When the list component is displayed, it will appear with three items showing at a time and scroll bars. By default, JList components added to a JScroll pane object only display a scroll bar if there are more items in the list than there are visible rows. When a JList component is added to a JScroll pane object, a border will automatically appear around the list. As you see, there are some examples at each chapter, and we will upload our lab sessions into Learning Management System of Fırat University. Please do not forget it to watch all of them. The setListData method allows the adding of items in an existing JList component. Thanks to this statement, this replaces any items that are currently displayed in the component. This can be used to add items to an empty list. You can create an empty list by using the JList components no parameter constructor, and this statement can be used for it, and items can be added to our list, what we studied on it previously. A single interval selection mode. A list is set to single interval selection mode by passing the constant with this statement to the components set selection mode method. An interval is a set of contiguous items. The user selects the first item in the interval by clicking on it, the last item by holding the shift key while clicking on it. Actually, shift key is used in Word 2. If you want to select more items, just you are clicking the shift key and you hold it. All of the items that appear in the list from the first item through the last item are selected. The getSelectedValue method returns the first item in the selected interval. The getSelectedIndex method returns the index of the first item in the selected interval. To get the entire selected interval, use the getSelectedValues method. This method returns an array of objects, which are the items in the selected interval. The getSelectedIndices method returns an array of integer values that are the indices of all selected items in the list. Now we can begin with multiple interval selection mode. Set multiple interval selection mode by passing the constant, just you are typing this statement, multiple interval selection, to the components set selection mode method. In multiple interval selection mode, multiple items can be selected. Actually, I showed you this action. And the items do not have to be in the same interval. It means you can select the first group, for example, three items, and you can jump to another items and collect all of them together. In multiple interval selection mode, the user can select single items or intervals. For doing that, we have to use the control key. And first of all, we are pressing the control key and then clicking on the item. It selects the item without deselecting other items. To get selected value method returns the first selected item. To get selected index method returns the index of the first selected item. The get selected values method returns an array of objects containing the items that are selected. The get selected indices method returns an integer array containing the indices of the selected items. Now I want to show you how can we select multiple interval selection in Java. As you see, here we have the names of the months, and we want to select only January, February, and March. Then we want to omit the April and May, but we want to select June with the previous selected three items together. And for doing that, just you are using the control key, and then you are clicking on the items what you want to select. Now we will begin with combo boxes. If we are discussing about the combo boxes, then you have to remember this type of the shape. A combo box presents a drop-down list of items that the user may select from. It means just you are coming to here and click the arrow which is directed to the below, and then you will see the other items under here. The JComboBox class is used to create a combo box, pass an array of objects that are to be displayed as the items in the drop-down list to the constructor. This is our names, and then you just write JComboBox name box, and then you are putting this part of the statement. When displayed, the combo box created by this code will initially appear as the button you see here, and since our first index is Bill, then Bill is located at the top of the combo box. If you click this arrow, then you will see the other names there. The button displays the item that is currently selected, for example here Bill. The first item in the list is automatically selected when the combo box is displayed. When the user clicks on the button, the drop-down list appears and the user may select another item from here. When an item in a JComboBox object is selected, it generates an action event. Handle action events with an action event listener class, which must have an action performed method. When the user selects an item in a combo box, the combo box executes its action event listener's action performed method, passing an action event object as an argument. There are two methods in the JComboBox class that can be used to determine which item in a list is currently selected. The first one is called getSelectedItem, and the second one is getSelectedIndex. The getSelectedItem method returns a reference to the item that is currently selected. And here the statement is shown. String selected name and selected name is equal to this statement. Get selected item returns an object reference, so we cast the return value to a string. The get selected index method returns the index of the selected items. As we remember, in Java programming language, index begins with zero. This is the zeroth string, and this is the first string, and this is the third one. And get the selected item from the names array. Just you are typing these statements, what you are seeing here, this code. Integer index, and then string selected name. Index is equal to name box dot get selected index, and selected name is equal to names index. In this example, in this slide, we want to show you how we retrieve the selected items. In the first box, you see combo box as regular coffee, but under regular coffee, you see there are other types of the coffees here are listed. And then if you select espresso from here, then in this combo box, you just select it and it is written here espresso. And there are two types of combo boxes. The first one is uneditable combo box. It means allows the user to only select items from its list. And editable means combines a text field and a list. It allows the selection of items from the list and allows the user to type input into the text field. The set editable method sets the edit mode for the component. And you have to use this statement to create editable combo boxes. An editable combo box appears as a text field with a small button displaying an arrow joining it. When the user clicks on the button, the drop-down list appears as shown in the center of the figure. The user may select an item from the list, type a value into the next field. The user is not restricted to the values that appear in the list and may type any input into the text field. Now we can understand what we are talking about. And as you know, in this slide, we are discussing about the editable combo boxes. And in our list, normally, we have these names. But thanks to editable combo, you can add Sharon into the combo box. Pay attention, please. The name of Sharon is not here in the list. Now, the question is that how can we display images in labels and buttons? Labels can display text and image or both of them together. To display an image, create an instance of the image icon class, which reads the image file. The constructor accepts the name of an image file. The supported file types are JPEG, GIF, and PNG. The name can also contain path information. For example, here we are giving information about our path, where the GIF icon should be selected or should be gotten. Display the image in a label by passing the image icon object as an argument to the JLabel constructor. You have to use this statement. The argument passes can be an image icon object or any object that implements the icon interface. And here you are typing label set icon image. Text is displayed to the right of the images by default. Text alignment can be modified by passing one of the following to an overloaded constructor. Here, swing constants left, swing constants center, swing constant right. Just you are typing this statement. Creating a button with an image is similar to that of the creating a label with an image. J button is equal to new J button image. To create button with an image and text, you are typing button set icon image. To add an image to an existing button, you are typing button set icon image. You are not limited to small graphical icons when placing images in labels or buttons. Mnemonic is a key that you press in combination with Alt key to quickly access a component. These are sometimes referred to as hotkeys. A hotkey is assigned to a component through the component set mnemonic method. The argument passed to the method is an integer code that represents the key you wish to assign. The key codes are predefined constants in the key event class. It means java.awt.eventpackage. These constants take the form keyevent.vk_x, where x is a key on the keyboard. The letters vk in the constant stands for virtual key. To assign a key as a mnemonic, use keyevent.vk_a. Example, exit button set mnemonic keyevent.vk_x. If the letter is in the components text, the first occurrence of that letter will appear underlined. If the letter does not appear in the components text, then no letter will appear underlined. You can also assign mnemonics to ready buttons and checkboxes too. As you see here, we are using ready button here. And for the first ready button, we are using breakfast. And then set mnemonic key event vk_b. B stands for breakfast there. And when you create this statement in your program, then we will see an underline sign under B. Tooltips. A tooltip is text that is displayed in a small box when the mouse is held over a component. The box usually gives a short description of what the component does. Most GUI applications use tooltips as concise help to the user. Assign a tooltip to a component with the setTooltipText method. And if you write here, click here to exit, then you will see this information here. And as you see, there is an underscore sign under X letter. File chooses. A file chooser is a specialized dialog box that allows the user to browse for a file and select it. In this figure you see a file chooser, and just you are coming to here, and after you click on it, then you are selecting this file. Create an instance of the JFileChooser class to display a FileChooser dialog box. Two of the constructors have the form JFileChooser, and you don't put anything here. And in the second form, JFileChooser string, and you are defining the path. The first constructor shown takes no arguments and uses the default directory as the starting point for all of its dialog boxes. The second constructor takes a string argument, you see here, containing a valid path. This path will be the starting point of the object's dialog boxes. A JFileChooser object can display two types of predefined dialog boxes. One of them is open file dialog box. It means it lets the user browse for an existing file to open. A save file dialog box lets the user browse to a location to save a file. To display an open file dialog box, use the show open dialog method. And this is the general form of it. integer show open dialog, component and parent. The argument can be null or a reference to a component. If null is passed, the dialog box is normally centered in the screen. If you pass a reference to a component, the dialog box is displayed over the component. To display a save file dialog box, use the show save dialog method. And this is the general statement of it. The argument can be either null or a reference to a component. Both methods return an integer that indicates the action taken by the user to close the dialog box. You can compare the return value to one of the following constants. JFileChooser cancel option, JFileChooser approve option, JFileChooser error option. If the user selected a file, use the getSelectedFile method to determine the file that was selected. And the getSelectedFile method returns a file object which contains data about the selected file. Use the file object's getPath method to get the path and file name as a string. You see the quotes here. Now about the color choosers. A color chooser is a specialized dialog box that allows the user to select a color from a predefined palette of colors. You see in this figure there are different types of the colors, and just you are coming to here and you are selecting from the small boxes. By clicking the HSB tab, you can select a color by specifying its hue, saturation and brightness. By clicking the RGB tab, you can select a color by specifying its red, green and blue components. The JColorChooser class has a static method named showDialog with the following general format. If the first argument is null, the dialog box is normally centered in the screen. If it is a reference to a component, the dialog box is displayed over the component. The second argument is the dialog title. The third argument indicates the color that appears initially selected in the dialog box. This method returns the color selected by the user. An example for it is given here. You see here, select a background color, and blue is used here, and panel set background selected color. What are the menus? A menu system is a collection of commands organized in one or more drop-down menus. We are familiar with file and edit menus. And for example, if you want to select the F, then you can hold down F and then you will get this menu system together. It is called drop-down menu. Under edit, as you see, we have menu items here. And then we have sub menus too for sorting. Ascending or descending is available. And the checkbox menu item, just you are selecting here how to save. And these are the radio button menu items. A menu system commonly consists of menu bar. A menu bar lists the names of one or menus. A menu is a drop-down list of menu items. A menu item can be selected by the user. A checkbox menu item appears with a small box beside it. The item may be selected or deselected. A radio button menu item may be selected or deselected. Submenu, a menu within a menu is called a submenu. Separator bar, a separator bar is a horizontal bar used to separate groups of items on a menu. Please check the previous slide in order to understand better what we are discussing. A menu system is constructed with the following classes. JMenuBar used to create a menu bar. A JMenuBar object can contain JMenu components. JMenu used to create a menu. A JMenu component can contain JMenu item, JCheckbox menu item, and JRadioButton menu item components, as well as other JMenu components. A submenu is a JMenu component that is inside another JMenu component. JMenu item used to create a regular menu item. A JMenu item component generates an action event when selected. JCheckbox menu item is used to create a checkbox menu item. The class is selected method returns true if the item is selected or false otherwise. A JCheckbox menu item component generates an action event when selected. JRadioButton menu item is used to create a RadioButton menu item. And JRadioButton menu item components can be grouped together in a button group object so that only one of them can be selected at a time. The class is selected method returns true if the item is selected or false. Otherwise, we are repeating the same things here. A JRadioButton menu item component generates an action event when selected. Text areas. The JTextField class is used to create text fields. A text field is a component that allows the user to enter a single line of text. A text area is like a text field that can accept multiple lines of input. You use the JTextArea class to create a text area. The general format of two of the class constructors. The first one is JTextArea, integer rows, integer columns, and then JTextArea, string text, integer rows, and integer columns. It means you can define the coordinate of the pixel, of the point. The JTextArea class provides the getText and setText methods for getting and setting the text. You see the statements are used here. JTextArea components do not automatically display scroll bars. You must add a text area to a scroll pane. And in this example, you see, we are selecting the coordinate as in x20 and in y direction 40. And we can input our text directly to that point. The JScrollPane object displays both vertical and horizontal scroll bars on a text area. Horizontal means this direction. And this is the vertical direction. By default, the scroll bars are not displayed until they are needed. This behavior can be altered. And you see the codes here. For example, here, vertical scroll bar always. Or horizontal scroll bar never. You can pass one of the following constants as an argument. Set horizontal scroll bar policy, set vertical scroll bar policy. T is missing here. It should be vertical. By default, JTextArea components do not perform line wrapping. To enable line wrapping, you have to use this statement. There are two different styles of line wrapping. The first one is word wrapping. The line breaks always occur between words. And the second one, characters wrapping. Line are broken between characters. This is the default mode. And now we are handling with fonts. Actually, what we are explaining here, just this is the reading material, and I am sure if you use one of them, then you should be able to understand the rest of them. But I don't want to miss anything, and therefore I am following our slides step by step and reading the lines together. And now we are continuing with fonts. Components display according to their font characteristics. Font, the name of the typeface. Style can be plain, bold, and or italic. Size of the text in points. A component's set font method will change the appearance of the text in the component. And this is a statement that we can use for setting of the font. A font constructor takes three parameters. These are string font name, integer style, and integer size. Java guarantees that you will have the fonts, dialog, dialog input, monospaced, sans serif, and serif. There are three font style, font plain, font bold, and font italic. Example, you see here, as font we are using serif, and this is the bold, and 24 is the size. And font titles can be combined adding them here, serif, this is the font style, and then it should be selected bold and italic together, and the size is 24. What are the sliders? A slider is a component that allows the user to graphically adjust a number within a range. You see, this is called slider. You can move it vertically up and down. Sliders are created from the JSlider class. They display an image of a slider knob that can be dragged along a track. Here we are seeing a slider which is directed to the vertical direction, while the other is directed as horizontal here. A slider is designed to represent a range of numeric values. As the user moves to knob along the track, the numeric values is adjusted accordingly. Between the minimum and maximum values, major ticks marks are displayed with a label indicating the value at that tick mark. Between the major tick marks are minor tick marks. The JSlider constructor has the general format. This is the general format of JSlider. For orientation, one of these constants should be used, whether you are using the horizontal direction or vertical direction. Here you see two sliders. The first one is directed to horizontal direction, while the second one is directed to vertical. And these are the scales, beginning from 0 to 50, and 25 is the scale interval. Set the major and minor tick mark spacing width. Set the major tick spacing or set minor tick spacing. You can write this slider 1, set major tick spacing 10, and slider 1, set minor tick spacing 2. Display tick Marx by calling set paint tick bars, and this is a statement, display numeric labels on the slider by calling set paint labels, and this is a statement, when the knob's position is moved, the slider component generates a change event. To handle the change event, write a change listener class. A change listener class must meet the following requirements. It must implement the change listener interface. It must have a method named state changed. This method must take an argument of the change event type. To retrieve the current value stored in a JSlider, use the getValue method. You see here, current value, slider 1, getValue. Look and feel. The appearance of a particular system's GUI is known as its look and feel. Java allows you to select the look and feel of a GUI application. On most systems, Java's default look and feel is called Metal. There are also Motif and Windows look and feel classes for Java. Motif is similar to a Unix look and feel. Windows is the look and feel of the Windows operating system. How can we change an application's look and feel? Just we are calling UI Manager class and static set look and feel method. Java has a class for each look and feel. The set look and feel method takes the fully qualified class name for the desired look and feel as its argument. The class name must be passed as a string. In this slide, you see how can we use Metal, Motif, or Windows look and feel. Just you have to use these statements. And in this slide, you see the differences between Metal look, Motif look, and Windows look and feel. And as you see, the shapes are changed thanks to selecting of the look and feel. Any components that have already been created need to be updated using with this statement. This method takes a reference to the component that you want to update as an argument. And you see the statements which can be used here. Please remember what we discussed about the try and catch for exception. And as you remember, if you use try, then it should be followed by catch. And in this example, you see motif, about the motif. And in this slide, you see look and feel for Windows. Here, please. Try to use this code when you are using Java in order to understand better what we are explaining. Finally, we could finish the chapter 13. This chapter was very long, but as you see, the contents are similar. Just we use the same things with different items, and I suggest you to read this chapter yourself, or you can follow the PowerPoint slides. And but it is very important to solve examples what we will upload into the learning management system of Fırat University. And on the other hand, you can use other materials in order to understand this topic well. Have a nice day and see you next week.